says, forget about the old things, for I will do a new thing for you. I will make a way in the wilderness, rivers in the desert for you. But lately your hope has gone, you've lost your faith, and you trust in no more. No, be lie.
You have not seen again is the Jesus Christ.
Okay.
I want to look at that Jesus Christ very well. My only interpretation of Jesus Christ is the black Jesus. That's why you can see that Jesus Christ is not light, is the dark one. Because from the history, I'm a student of history. I find out that Jesus Christ, the one those from Arimathea, they are black. And history has proven that. But because of the politics, the war politics,
Western
between
politics,
white and black, they seem to turn the Jesus to white. All the same, I believe what is good in blacks, they always adopt it and try to transform it to their own point. But still, I believe that we are still serving the same Jesus Christ, the Savior of mankind. Like what many people may not know, I believe so much in scriptures. As God we have it, like I told you, I was born into Anglican family. And my mother even raised the bar, because I remember there was time that my mother with others, they joined some evangelical group. The Anglican, we call it Evangelion. And I remember that I followed her virtually to the entire Korean houses that I think we were living in Korea. And we were really into evangelism. And from there, I know the efficacy of prayer. And what it is.
Wonderful.
Where the Bible says, God said, let's create man in our own image. I believe in the image of God. And you may not believe this. I don't believe in standing before any prophet before God can answer a prayer. It's just for you to know the capacity of what God has put in you.
Wonderful.
And go on out
and achieve it.
To achieve it. It's like you are it's like you're activating the power. Some of us may not know that. Through prayer and fasting.
Okay, through prayer and fasting.
Through prayer and fasting.
Mountains are moved.
Mountains are moved, of course. And everything is about faith. You have the faith. Though, like I do say this, Jesus Christ symbolizes that to me. And this is something that I've been made to believe that it comes to this world. If you don't want to believe in God, and in your sin and His image, well, you are still the image. And by the time you follow the teaching of Bible, now I'm not being scriptural. I'm saying the way it is. Well, you know, before the emergence of Bible of Christ.
Yeah.
There have been a lot of theories about faith, about religion. This one will come with his own.
Yeah.
They preach, all they preach is fear and war.
That's Moses, the law of Moses.
The law of Moses, the law, the Islam, the Hindus, the Judaism, all. It's more of to have the followership, to have the obedience. You must be feared.
Yeah.
All the draconian law. But Jesus Christ came. He brought peace. He brought that peace. And that's why he talked about love. Love your neighbor and God. Because it never before the advent of Jesus Christ, nobody ever believed that you can get people obedience, you can get people for followership in being love alone. You have to show your follower that
you are strong.
And that's why you have the Herod and Agrippa. You can see Caesar that sent people to
head.
Use feed people with the lions and gold. But Jesus Christ came. And to bring that spirit of love.
Maybe you can relate it to Mahatma Gandhi.
Of course, and that's one thing. And that's one thing we have to do. And the essence, the greatest achievement, what we need in this world is peace. You see, though peace will continue to be elusive as long as human beings reside on earth. because you see different struggles from one family to another, from even before this two children to street, from street to community, from community to local government, local government to state, to the world. You see it will continue to be strives here and there, but the teaching of Jesus Christ, please calm it. I like one imam. One imam, we were talking one day. When I told him,
an imam,
we were discussing about world peace and what is happening in the world and social order. Say, what the Christianity, what is Islam, what other faith-based organization, what they are doing. I mean, I won't know. Now, if I want to know, the only way for you to know is that despite all this, you see the number of pastors, you see the number of imams, you see the number of all those worshippers talking about morality, talking about peace, you can see how confusion is all over. Then I should just imagine we don't have anything like Christian, Muslim, and all this. Can you imagine what would have happened?
Jesus Christ.
And
chaos.
Of course.
Anarchy.
That's what it is. And that's why when you check this quotation, that way it talks about human beings, they are the best of human, they are the best form of animal species. But take law and order from it, they are the beast. So, his advent at least brings sanity to the world, and that is Jesus Christ. And mind you, when you check that Jesus Christ, where he's black Jesus.
Yes, I'm surprised.
Because black
Jesus,
because of the history. Jesus is from Aramantia. And when you know civilization come from the black race, and when you check, those are the Judea and Aramantia. From what I've learned, from what I've read, and from where I've visited, you find out that they are black. Though some people tell you that no, they are colored, but one thing is about the way the northern media, the northern leaders wanted to believe that Jesus is white. No, he's not.
Yes,
they want to say Jesus is white. Jesus is not white. Jesus is not white. That one is so clear. Because how can you? It's been there for, you know, Jesus is from Africa. That one is so clear. Nobody can be that. No, some people will say it's Middle East. But we should be sincere. Jerusalem is Middle East. Jerusalem is Africa. And that's why you see. Anyway, I won't like to bore you. I will have just tell you a little about what Caesar that married Cleopatra. That's Anthony Caesar. See, by the time he took over the Egypt, then he has to annex Ethiopia and some areas in Africa.
Sudan.
And it got to even down to Sudan, even down to where we're staying.
In Nigeria.
It got to the point that all these generals then, they are black. But funny enough, generals, they are the one, the generals that make all the Caesars, they are blacks. Because, you know, of course, blacks is very strong. They are very strong. But today, how many of them have been Western media been able to acknowledge?
Absolutely.
Mention the great general. Mention Hannibal and Co. All of them are blacks. They are poorly black.
Even Hannibal.
Maximo is black. He's from the Mazima. That's where they got Mazima.
The one Mazima.
It's so clear that it's black. But nobody, even when you look at this pattern, that's in the Greeks area, all of them. Those that mix in check, even if you meet somebody, they won't tell you how they look. They have a pale skin. These are the way, but unfortunately, the way they will spin the story
and change it.
But anyway, whatever it is, Jesus, I believe in Jesus Christ. And from what you can see, like I mentioned, what happened to Kayode Ajulo.
Yes,
Kayode Ajulo made me to be a lawyer. Made me to first make my decision that this is what I wanted to be. Because all those people that have never been to my father's shop,
bookshop,
you know, is, you know, CSS bookshop.
Yes, sir.
You know how big and it's possible that if in Ibadan, those from Ife, from girls of Ife, from Ibadan, any school, you find them there, kings, some will even place another. You'll be surprised if I tell you that Oni of Ife, his pen for his coloration, he got it from even my father had to travel out of the country to secure it in London. For you to know how it
that's
is.
That's the
only Olubushe. That's 1980. And people will come, but of all those people as at that time, were at that point, that come, I noticed that my dad was bad, one person more than anything. And to me, I'm not even saying that the money, I'm not even saying that the cloth, I don't have any dresses dressed well. It's with bow tie today. I'm still wearing the bow tie. I'm not not just waiter bow tie, this self tie bow tie that you have to tie, you have to use it, the bow tie, the same wearing and so that I adopted that one, and it made me forced to think of I must be the lawyer. It depends on who is narrating this.
Okay.
Whatsoever you see, when you talk of being a Yoruba man, when you say Yoruba, they are men of valor, they are strong men. He is a signpost of that. He's poster boy of being poster man of being a great Yoruba that very, very Yoruba has their strength, their character, they are fearless. And that's Adekunle for you. Today, anytime you talk about Nigerian history, there's no way you won't mention Adekunle. They will let you know that it's Obasanjo that signed.
Of course, that got the surrender.
It is the group, the men.
So some people said Adekunle sold the nation to the opposition.
Certainly, you know this. You know when it comes to spinning story, but one thing stands out: he fought the war tirelessly. He fought the war with all what he has, and his name. There's no way you can raise
it.
Even when there's no honor till today, just imagine if now there's official honor, you can see what it is. And the man, quite fearless. And one thing I found in him, and I think I should be a living testimony of his magnitude. We met at Sheraton Hotel. The first day he met me, he called me and said, "Oh, you are a young man. What are you doing in the hotel? Why are you wasting your time? You speak a good history." I told him, I want to go to university. Which of the university? The next morning, I saw him knocking at my door and said, "Let's go." He took me to Joss.
Are you seeing this?
I'm serious. This is somebody that I met.
You've not told anybody this history before.
I do mention it, but I've not even.
Please,
I'm here to even explain the
whole. Yes.
Took me inside the car, drove me to the University of Joss, asked for the VC. This is I dropped a note and told me, "I don't want to see you." You know the way he is
erratic. Very erratic.
I don't want to see you around anywhere again because you waste your life there. And drop a message to the VC and told me that he's on his way to put to school. That if he's on his way, he will pick me.
Jesus.
Unfortunately, I found myself there, waited for him, so I have to find my way to Abuja. After about 3 months, he saw me again. He said to do thing, he shouted, "What are you doing here? I told you want to waste your time. You are in charity. Your mates should not be until where you are." That's why until today, each time, at least once in a while, we just took my family to the charity lodging presidential just to remember that. Because we told me, "Look, you are wasting your life away. At what age? You are just 16, 17. You think you've arrived. You must. It will be a time that you even enjoy." And really, it really helped. That is how I became a student of the University of Joss. No thanks to you.
Jesus Christ. Delayed gratification.
Yeah, definitely. And each time we tell you, "Come over to Lagos, I do visit him in Cartes." Really, it's broke, but I believe with this, some youth need to speak out, because each time I'm in his house, you see nothing less than 20 young university undergraduate that will tell you it's a Adekunle that sent them to school. No, we never give you anything. We never even give you pocket money, but we'll tell you not to have done the best for you, I've got you. And in NDA, you still need to at least that, and you see some first timer, second timer, two timer. To the final time in Ezra is the big hill. All of them will pack ourselves there, will come down, speak to us, tell you good about life. And that's why that one reminds me, and that one reminds you that anybody that come across your way, you must try to impact something, because if somebody wants, somebody will pick it, will pick something up.
Then what does Awolowo mean?
Then you know, of course, Awolowo, even before I was born, is a sage, is leader of Yoruba, is undisputable one. Nobody till today, irrespective of the political correlation, you know, that's the authentic Asuaju of Yoruba. I still remain. Nobody, even despite you see at the Sakin way, they are pulled apart, they still give him that honor. You mentioned who is alive. Akinde is alive. If you ask him about Awolowo, Adedibo, despite the old issue, still believe him, will tell you that one of the Abilene was one of Awolowo's. And again, when you look at the spiritualism, the intellectualism, everything Awolowo combined together, his pattern life is something I always look up to. It's true. As a lawyer, come money comes your way, earthquake comes your way, but you should not miss that point that look. no matter whatever it is, the code of conduct, as how you live your life, Awolowo at least ensure that he inscribed that in the some of her heart. And he's somebody that, okay, even I'm honored to have it, to have his portrait in the office.
And when Mahatma Gandhi
as a young man, I remember that I read so much about him. Unfortunately, he died before he died before I was born. But I've read something. But one thing about Mahatma Gandhi that you cannot tell is that he's very resilient.
Highly.
No matter what, and he stands on his principle. And in respect of that, he abhors violence. Being somebody that true, I believe he should be one of the first in the history of, in the modern history of mankind, that we use peace, peacefulness, non-violence method to achieve something that you use violence to achieve. Like what Boko Haram is doing, exactly is what Gandhi, non-violence, without taking anything, and the for the British Empire to stand still, at the end of the day, he won. He got the credence to his people. Unlike, because I like reading history. You can see what happened to the Mau Maus.
Yes.
You can see what happened to the Agbekoya. But this is a man. Peaceful, you should know. For somebody to do that, it reminds you that you can achieve some tough issue by being doing it peacefully through dialogue. And he achieved that.
And then we have Martin Luther King.
Martin Luther King.
What does he say to you?
Martin Luther King, you need to receive some of his quotation. He's like, each time you look at them, you see most of
those things.
I have a dream. Then, you know, people always talk about I have a dream. One of his best quotation is the one that talk about compassion. Mm-hmm. Let you know that true compassion is not toasting just pen into a beggar. Real true compassion is trying to find out how the beggar come to be.
And
way to change the beggar's life, to work on the system, to ensure that this man is not a beggar. Because what you see in our, with our allies, with our leaders, is to start saying they were doing empowerment, they'll be giving you grinding machine.
No, rise inside line.
That is not compassion. That is not for sure. My doctorate is in corporate social responsibility.
Your doctorate thesis?
Yes, is in social corporate responsibility. That you now know that the real corporate social responsibility is not flinging money, buying schools and everything, but to know how to change the system.
Okay.
That is one of the things you see,
for Nelson Mandela.
Anyway, I don't think to our generation Nelson Mandela did not need any introduction.
I know.
For 27 years
in prison,
somebody without his wife, without anything, in custody for 27 years. I'm here to see any greater sacrifice than anybody. Our leaders today, he will buckle. All this thing, and one thing again, you see him with all these people, is the issue of resilience. It's so clear, and they stand, they have, each of them has a principle that one has to emulate. That one, Mandela stand out for that.
Then we have Gani Fawehinmi,
of course. Wow. Gani Fawehinmi, you know, when it comes to it, don't know me that I'm going to practice law. You know, there are a lot, laws, it depends on which side you want to be. That want to be like Roting Williams. That want to be like a Capashion. That want to be like Commission Law Chubu. If you got to point that to me, Commission Law Chubu, I want to be a very good friend. Then used to come to Sheraton, like I told you, that's where I'm
Sheraton
Abuja. We met, funny enough, was even the one that filled my jam form then. And but when it comes to finding Gani Fawehinmi, you notice that his own principled, this method is at least is something else. This is somebody that can stood before the tank, armored tank, and say shoot me. You know what it is. And without compromising, all his life he never compromised. We became so close before he died. I remember each time he would tell us, look, there is some way that, and I remember he used to say something. There was a day he showed me his briefs. He said he have over 6,000 briefs.
Yeah,
and I would know 6,000 and most of these briefs are free. And but to me, I may not know of any other person. He died as one of the most successful legal practitioners in Nigeria. You need to see where his will was read. You need to see what even gave out. And this is somebody that even the briefs it collects money from is not that much. Though many people will tell you after all he's a publisher.
Yeah.
Yes, he's the Almighty God
that
Buddha. And what I'm saying is this, most of today's activists, they seem to compromise.
They are touch activists.
Most of them, they're now looking for money. And I must say this, even it got to a point that the civil society organization, some section of this country seem to be a specialist in that. And I remember that this is one of the things Gani Fawehinmi fought. I remember, if you remember that, when he was even trying to castigate Beko Rankusankuti to say, look, civil society organization is not to make money. I'm an NGO, Egalitarian Mission Africa.
Okay.
Today, we have never, and I think we not, because what I just did is that 10% of the profit after tax from my office will go to God. And that's what we are doing, because that one will now make you as a civil society organization to be focused, to know what it is and say it as it is.
Yes.
Doubt,
yes. Fear of favor.
But the situation that before you do anything, you first send proposal to one civil to one organization, to one donor company, it's rubbish. It should not be. Like I mentioned, some section of the country, they now seem to be a specialist in civil society.
We know that.
Which is wrong. Even they have known that they're even having a clique, call it the institutional room and all those ones.
Institutional room.
It is wrong. Can if I despite all never to the my best knowledge and to other, never compromise, never even ask for money. What God gave him is what is. And some people, like I mentioned, some people say, of course, he's a publisher. That's for you to know that the Almighty God, if you realize what you are doing and you are doing what is right, we find a way for you that you be what you want to be. It should be a lesson.
Yes.
To some of us, and that is. And anyway, I need not even say so much about that.
Okay, let's go because you are so very, you are so partial. The only literary guy who is not a lawyer, what does it mean to you? No, what does it mean to you?
Look, let me say something. As a young man.
Yeah,
you will not believe it. I've all his books, of course.
You read all those great commercial English.
Even those books. I remember that as a young man when you want to write a letter to your girlfriend. When I was in private secondary school. You were even at that time, and maybe let me use this one to apologize. To always encourage that even you is, should I say, one would pick the entire page. The only change maybe if I'm writing the name of the lady or some other things. Like I remember that time when he was saying my something jar over the jug of water. Who will understand what it is? But when it comes to that, he represents intellectualism.
Yes,
he represents that capacity and give it to him. Though sometimes I may not agree with one of what he's saying.
Yeah.
That's why recently when he said he's going to I quickly sent an advice to him that you are going to jail if you do that. And I thank the Almighty God that he never did it. Because my worry is this, I have nothing against the Malaysian. Yeah. He's one of those. I think this one you want to show that. You can see his portrait.
No, I can see his portrait.
I worship him, let me even say that. I respect him, but even if you have a rabbi, a teacher, if your teacher should go wrong,
you should have a say.
And you need to really point to the consequence. Because he is a model. He inspire people.
Yep.
Some of us, even Wale Jenka should kill somebody today, we believe that is the right thing to do, we start killing.
I know.
A property that belongs to someone, that means that if husband and wife should be fighting tomorrow, instead for them, they should pick it, might have a tear it a piece. So if I'm fighting my wife, all I need to do is to get the car that I bought for her to use pest to mess up car. That is why, as a follower, I know that Wale Jenka tells that some people that he make use of disparaging words against some of us. I don't think I belong to that category because this is from my heart. The advice given to Wale Jenka is what I would give to my father. If my father should tend to go astray as a lawyer, he is not a lawyer.
Yeah.
Then I think we know this law and we need to point it out. Destroying property, even destroying your property, your own property. Destroy your property.
Yes, sir.
You have a criminal liability.
So
you can't just set. I can't say this house belongs to me and just set it on fire. No, their mother's.
I'm hearing this for the first time.
No, sure. You can't say this is my property, and I choose to set it on fire. If I really want to get it down, get the permit and then get the those those that do that, then let them bring it down in a peaceful manner, not that you should just set it on fire. Barack Obama is a symbol of what symbol of aspiration of the whole world. Whole world in the old sense that if you remember, you can see Martin Luther King that say, "I have a dream that one day my son, back of back, we walk together." Not even what he failed to say is that the son of a black man will be in White House. Black man at White House. You can see the construct, but it happened. That shows that this world, we are living in a world of possibility. Nothing is impossible. It is just a dream. And at the time when he was dreaming, I remember about 3 years ago, I met Jason Jackson in Abuja. He came from Chief Clark, one of Chief Clark Foundation, and we discussed. He said, look, Barack Obama, he's not seeing Barack Obama. Because what he's saying is that symbol of that hope and possibility that it is possible. With that, it is possible. Whatsoever anybody may think of, it is possible. And with God, everything is possible. So by trying to talk about personality of Obama, it's like I'll be doing great disservice to what he represents to the whole world. He represents something new. Mind you, not up to a century, his progenitors, grandfathers, fathers who have been chilled abroad. With somebody, you need to go to Philadelphia, you need to go to Atlanta, go to most of the museum, because most of the time when I'm on holiday, I'm out of the country. Those are the things, because one need to acquire knowledge. You need to see what is done to as late as about 60 years ago, 50 years ago, you see what is done to our to blacks in America. Yes. Even as if a few years ago, there was even the American president. That's the one that established Liberia. We're even trying to proclaim a law how to send them back to America. And one of the reasons is that these people may take over their country.
Someday.
It happened. So it's like
fear and a prophecy.
Thank you. Obama is a prophecy that comes true. So to me, it gives me that courage anytime you are in a problem, you look at him and say, it's possible.
I agree with you.
And again, you may not know this. Each time I'm flying, because I fly at least once in a week, I must be on the air. Each time a plane went to land, I do ask myself that question. Whosoever have this thinking that this bird is coming will come down. And sometimes I'll close my eyes, then you see the engine of the plane will be talking to you, see the way they'll be changing. You know, it's like possible. If somebody can do it, then everything is possible. So some of the things you see one doing most of the time, there's some power. It's quite inspirational. Tell you one thing, I'm so much apart from love. One of the things that put me in right frame of mind is music. That's why when you get to that to the love, my love, that you see,
yes, I see piano, yes.
So it's just unfortunate. Yes. I don't play,
but you love music.
Good hands in Abuja that each time we always have a timetable, particularly like evening like this, you bring them, they will play a very good song. I'm talking of him, Christian song, all those. Aliyah Kuros sing all those songs that inspire you. And let me tell you this secret. Anytime I'm writing a book, I teach you that I can't write a book without listening to good music.
It happens to me too.
That flow is like, I remember some of my friends who said, when they take marijuana, some will tell you that when they are drunk, I don't smoke, I don't drink. But let me listen to
good very good music.
You see, even the next day, I will be reviewing the briefs or the action. How many
you write it?
You need to listen to good music. Handel, you need to Bethlehem, you need to all of my. I'm an Anglican. You play good.
Yeah,
you need to see all those, all who hear the king. When they play it, the spirit it will come down. And you write it's like a spirit in heaven come. And apart from that, if you have been following me.
Yes, sir.
I always believe that you should do your thing differently. Fela personified that. Many people may say that Fela seem to go against the system. No, system is always the issue at the life.
Yeah.
That one never works with me. I want to do things what my conviction. Fela follow his conviction. Those people call him different name, but they sell him. Fela has been separated. You need to be out of the country. That's when you know what is Fela. Just very close here, West End here in UK. You'll be there, go to any club, let them play Fela, you see the way it's like, It's like when I was in the club then, when the DJ play any of Fela music, it's as if, you know, the way we used to, when Nepa comes, all Fela, people say, hey, it's only they hail him as if they brought the light. I even asked them, say, no, it's Fela, you are pointing to me, isn't it your brother? I said, yes, hey, of course, I won't say no.
No.
Yeah, you feel so proud.
Proud.
We are from that
heritage.
We are the one that may not know what
we have.
So by the time you read Follow Fela, he speaks his mind.
I know.
Whether right or wrong. Because that is one of the major problems we have in this country. Mm. The leaders, they are afraid to speak. And not only, even to speak to the populace, the problem, not to speak to power that be.
Yes.
You must have that. And once you can do that, you'll be able to move. Mm. That is what we You know, I told you about Fela.
Yes.
One of the things I told you about what made Fela so dear to my heart is that he speaks his mind. He never do things because that's what is best. I know it's always the expectation that when you have your mother, you have your father. But you know, I would be myself. I so much respect my father. And mind you, my name is Olu Kayode Ajulo. Okay. Ajulo is my father's name. I carry his name all over the world. Wherever I find myself, you see. Even many people call me Ajulo than Kayode. So I think he has a rightful place. But my mom, he has done so much. I may not say much because I'm very emotional.
Okay.
He's alive. She's alive. Okay. I'm very emotional.
Alive.
Of course, she's still alive. I'm very emotional when it comes to my mom. Don't be surprised, I may break down. So I won't be able to say so much.
Okay, okay.
But he has so contributed so much.
Okay.
She started her life as a seamstress.
Hmm.
And that's why if you can see one of those what I have there, that's a hand machine, if you remember. It reminds me each time I'm getting to this room, it reminds me. That's how she started.
Hmm.
Though she retired to be she started from that to be a bookseller.
Hmm.
But one thing still stands out from that is that throughout in my house, my mother sewed all her clothes.
Hmm.
Even today, I have been sewing my clothes myself. Hmm. I designed all my clothes myself. Hmm. That is one thing.
And so you gain that from your mom?
Of course I
do. So you are even a tailor too?
Actually, I do tell you. When somebody says, you are fashionable, I say, I thought that's from my mom. So you know, there are some things that you can't take away.
Hmm.
Everything in this office is just to inspire you.
Hmm.
That is my mom is so much. And when you look at this,
you want to tell
this,
us her name?
No, her name is Mojisola.
Okay, sir.
Mojisola Christiana.
Okay.
And when you look at, though she has some other names too.
Okay, sir.
Though, if you look at this picture, if you look at it very well, to me, that is my own Madonna. You know, you really Madonna. When you look at the Madonna is like, people say it's like the heart.
Yes.
Despite being a work of art. This, I have so much, a lot of pictures and photos of my mom, but I took this one personally. And each time I look at, because that day I remember I was about to leave her, and you know, mommy, mother will always look.
They won't want
so emotional.
And when you're
going, I got that
emotional mood.
That emotional without makeups, without anything. That's natural as she is. So each time I'm looking at it, even you won't believe it. Sometimes I can't look at that picture twice in a day because it evokes
emotion,
some feeling from you.
Yeah.
So and that's
so this is the